So we put our record out a few months back. We did a tour with Iron Maiden over in Europe, which was probably our biggest tour we've ever done with this band.
That's
And
awesome.
it was a good 7 weeks that we were out. And we had about a month off. Now we're out here in the States for about a month. And then we're headed back over to Europe to do about 5 weeks of touring in November, December. After that, we're going to tour the United States with an undisclosed band because it hasn't been announced yet. But it's a tour we should have done for a lot of years with some good friends of ours. We're hitting Shiprocked, which is a great show we do on the Shiprock cruise line, and it's just a ton of fun. And so we'll put about a month of a tour around Shiprocked, and then depending on what else is happening, we'd like to go to Australia. We'd like to maybe get down to South America, some one of those two markets maybe before I have to hit the studio with Alter Bridge in March and April. And then after that, we hit the ground running with European summer festivals next year and try to get one last hurrah in before the Dying Machine cycle's over and we have to switch gears and get into Alter Bridge. Oh, you know, I'm very proud of all my endorsed musical equipment. You know, it's you know, we're on the Morley site now. I love my Morley pedals. I've always loved them. It's just good to have products that you're putting out there that you believe in. I'm not just getting approached by somebody like, yeah, it'd be cool to have this pedal, so I'm just going to use some no-name thing. I like to use what I actually believe in, and I've always believed in all the brands I support. And you know, with the Morley pedals, we've done a few different versions of it. We've just done the mini version Dying Machine
Yeah, that's
art,
super
which is
cool.
super cool. Eric actually helped me film the video that everybody sees online.
I made the video, guys.
He's the director.
I didn't know
He's
that.
the editor, director, all those good things. And then with PRS, I've got you know, a new amp that I'm extremely excited about because I'm an amp guy. You know, I'm an amp fanatic. So I voiced this thing for about a year and a half, and I was nervous about putting it out because I'd be really pissed if somebody said something bad about it. So finally put it out, and everybody loves it. It got best in show at NAMM, and I couldn't be happier because I had so much emotionally behind the release of this amp. So I'm glad it's done well. The guitars with PRS have always been, you know, my staple guitars. We're always coming out with new additions and versions of those main things. I'm working on a 100-watt version of the MT15 now with PRS, but always keep an eye out. There's always something new on the horizon.
When Mark switches over and we finish the cycle, when he goes to do Alter Bridge, I'll probably go to McDonald's or Starbucks and apply. No. Actually, I do a lot of session work as much as I can and stay around my daughter. I have a 5-year-old, so I try to stay close to her as much as I can because I'm gone so long on the road for this stuff. But I do session work, and I'm also in another band with some of the guys from Seven Dust called Projected. But we share a drummer with Alter Bridge, Flip, so it's always been hard. We've only played one live show. So we're trying to maybe like try to get a tour of all of them together and then just bring Flip on the bus and see what, you know. But yeah, I just try to stay busy and do a bunch of different things, yeah.
No, I don't know if I'm allowed to release that. You know, the promoters will come after me. I've gotten in so much trouble for releasing stuff early over the years, I just zip it.
Ain't nothing.
Just
What you got?
the MT100, you know, it's I've gotten one version of it, and it just wasn't sounding perfect. So turns out the output transformer was something messed up with it, so they're fixing that now, sending it back to me. But the biggest thing that for us to hunt down on this amp is just all the different transformers we could use on that amp. That's, I think, a big factor in the tone, because I want the actual preamp of the amp to sound almost identical to the MT15. I just want the big brother of the MT15 that keeps those tones, but just more of everything, more
same
low end,
voicing, yeah.
same tightness, same crystal clean, clear cleans. You know, but it's the good thing. The hardest thing to do is to make a small amp, because you're so limited to space. Now when you have the bigger amp, you can do all kinds of, you can add some features to it that we haven't done yet. But I'm kind of on the fence. I might just keep it simple, simple, clean, because that's what I like to use live. And we were, you know, with any band that you've had for a long time, you're always trying to think of the next thing that will cause some new waves out there. And our manager had said, I've got this thing, you know, it's crazy, but what do you think about playing with an orchestra? And we'll do it at Royal Albert Hall. You know, do a classy, not a metal show, but a strip sort of set down to where it would fit the orchestra. And so we did. And you know, it turned out to probably be the greatest night of our lives on stage, you know, with the symphony and the orchestra. But we filmed two nights at the Royal Albert Hall. It was a 52-piece orchestra. The set list, I think, is 20-plus songs. We did a lot of songs that we usually don't play live much, you know, because we wanted to play the songs that fit the orchestra better. We put out the live CD to accompany it, the Blu-ray, art booklet and whatnot, but we're very proud of it. I would say thanks for the continued support. You know, if there's ever an opportunity to come see us, we'd love to meet you. We're easy to find. Like I said, after every single show, we do a meet and greet for whoever wants to be there. You know, we usually go to the merch booth afterwards. If anybody's bought anything, we'll put a signature on it and meet everybody. You know, we do the pre-show meet and greets. We do, me and Eric do guitar clinics, teach anybody who wants to play guitar. So we
love meeting the people, man.
We're very hands-on. Awesome. And through this process, we've gotten to know so many people so well that whenever we go to a city, we have probably 30 familiar faces in every city. So it feels like you're always around friends. So it's a big family, you know, a lot of camaraderie, a lot of friends being made amongst the fans too, which I think is super cool. It's like this rock fraternity of sorts, you know.
Yep.